Hey, if you are looking for to learn classification of DC generator, different types of DC generator, then this is the video for you. In this video, I am going to explain classification with circuit diagram and wiring diagram, and all these things is going to be with animations. So stay tuned to this video, watch this video till the end. At the end section, I am also going to tell you how you can remember all these things. So let's quickly jump to the video. Hey, welcome to another video on video lecture series on DC generator. In this video, we are going to learn classification, circuit diagram, wiring diagram with animation. So let's jump to the video. DC generator are mainly classified into two categories. The one is self-excited DC generator and the another one is separately excited DC generator. Now let us check the separately excited DC generator first. There is a field winding in separately excited DC generator which is excited through a separate source. Now let's check the cross-sectional view of this separately excited DC machine. The field winding of this machine is arranged in this manner. Now let's see in connection diagram, there is an armature and the two terminal of this armature is connected to the load. If we see cross-sectional diagram, then armature is placed like this and the two terminals are taken out, which is given to the load. Now let's talk about self-excited DC generator. This self-excited DC generator is further classified into three categories: shunt generator, series generator and compound generator. In this three type, we will see shunt generator first. In a shunt generator, there is a field winding which is arranged in this manner. If we observe its cross-sectional view, then the shunt winding is arranged in this manner in a shunt generator. The armature is connected parallel to the shunt winding, or it is vice versa. You can even call it as field winding is connected parallelly with armature winding. If you observe its cross-sectional view, then the armature winding is connected in this manner. So this is how field winding and armature winding is arranged in shunt generator. Now if we talk about applications of DC generator, no. Not in this video. For applications of all different types of DC generator, I have prepared a separate video and the link for that video I'll provide in description box below or above here in card. So you can check out these things later on. You know, this connection diagram are very much important whenever you are understanding the working of DC generator or whenever you are solving the numericals on DC generator. So this section is very much important before understanding the working of generator and solving the numerical of DC generator. Now let's check series generator. In series generator, the armature winding and field winding, they both are connected in series with each other. If we observe its cross-sectional view, then you can observe that armature winding and field winding are placed like this. You can observe that how they are connected in series with each other. With this diagram, it would be easier for us to understand how this DC generator works. And if you want to understand with animations that how actually all these DC generator functions works, then I have prepared a separate animated video for this thing, and I'll provide the link for that video in description box below or above here in card. You can watch that thing later on. Right now, we'll quickly jump to the third type, which is compound generator. This compound generator is further classified into two categories. One is long shunt generator and the another one is short shunt generator. From these two, first of all, we'll see a long shunt generator. In long shunt and short shunt generator, the only difference is the connection of its shunt field winding. basically this compound generator is combination of series generator and shunt generator. The field winding is divided into two sections. One section is connected in series with armature winding and the another section is connected in shunt with armature winding. And the manner, the way they are connected with armature winding, the manner they are connected with the combinations of one field winding and armature winding, they are divided into two categories, long shunt generator and short shunt generator. So now in long shunt generator, there is an armature and one section of field winding is connected in series with armature. You can see in this manner. Now the another half of field winding is connected parallelly with the combination of one half of field winding and armature winding. You can observe the same thing on screen right now. If you observe its cross-sectional area, then the armature and field winding, which are connected in series with each other, they can be connected like this. And the another section of shunt field winding is connected in this manner. So this is how we can understand the connection diagram and winding diagram of long shunt generator. Now we'll move towards the short shunt generator. The armature and field winding are connected in series in short shunt generator. If we talk about cross-sectional view, then the cross-sectional view is arranged in this manner. It is the same as the long shunt generator. The only difference is in another half of field winding. Another half of field winding is connected in parallel to only armature winding. If we see the same thing in cross-sectional view, then you can connect it in this manner. So this is how a short shunt generator's circuit diagram and a cross-sectional view can be seen. So this is your full classification. Classification of DC generator. Now I will tell you how you can remember the classification of DC generator. But before jump into that, there is a quick short question for you, which is on your display. Do not forget to give answer of this question in comment section below. I request everybody, please write answer of this question in comment section below. The aim of asking this question is just to give you a verification check that exactly what you have learned from this video. Do not forget to give a like to this video, because your one like means a lot for us. That gives too much motivation, because making this type of video is require a lot of efforts and time. So you need to just hit that like button, which gives us so much motivation, and in future we will make more and more animated videos for you. Now let's quickly jump to the remembering trick. You need to remember in this manner, DC generator are mainly classified into two categories. In that, self-excited generator are further classified into three categories. And from that, compound generator is further classified into two categories. So you need to remember DC 232. So DC generator is mainly divided into two categories, which is further divided into three categories, which is further divided into two categories. So this is how you can remember this thing. One more thing, if you want to learn anything more about DC machine, then write that thing in comment section below. I will make video on that topic. Especially, I will make animated video on that topic. For more info on DC machine, multisim, MATLAB, latest topics like electrical vehicle, you can check out these useful videos on my channel. And do not forget to subscribe and give like to this video. So until we meet in our next video, till that time, bye-bye.